Brothers and sisters, shalom all. How you doing? Just a little note. And it's kind of a summary of what Revelations is really about in terms of the large specter of it. If you look at the scripture with spiritual eyes, Revelations is meant for Israel. So is the entire book, if you think about it. Who is everything directed towards, except a few here and there? But who is it mainly toward? Israel. Israel in terms of being a holy, chosen people. Israel, when they're misbehaving, to get back to him, sends his son so that Israel might have a way back to him. Everything. And it's just the missing link is, you know how children, when they're disobedient, they can't see the error of their own ways. They think the parent is the problem. Everybody else is the problem but them. You know, so they're going to continue to do what they want to do, because being bad and being rebellious is, it feels good for now. And a lot of them live in the moment more than foreseeing the outcome of their misendeavors. So that's how a lot of them like to live in the moment, instead of looking outside themselves. And I mean, not really like, or stepping back and trying to figure out, like, what is this really about? Many people keep fair in Revelations, but with the insight through the Spirit of the Most High, the Spirit of Truth, and what is set upon me to reveal, it's all about you. And even when it comes to, he sends the message to the churches, the seven churches, it's within you, right? Because he said one-thirds, and there are some people, of course, there's always some people who interpret it for their own selfish, lustful ways. Some people who were, what were they doing? Yeah, they were trying to justify a covenant outside of the nations. Fornication, basically, because that's what the Most High calls it. When you go out to other nations, you're fornicating with idols and you're disobeying him. So they were trying to justify their behavior, bad behavior. And that it just gets worse when you actually use the Spirit of Truth to justify bad behavior and sin. It's just the heights of disrespect to the Most High. So Revelations, in a nutshell, it is a way to show you how the Most High is trying to refine those who are still disobedient. They still want to go their own way. They still can't see the error of their own ways. And that's why he said for the church he has found no fault with, the remnant, they have been going wherever the Lamb go. They get it. They get it. They are sick and tired of it. They don't want no more of this. They get it. They have been refined. They keep his laws, his commandments. They understand it's not about just fasting and praying, but the whole, they see the big picture. Fast, pray, being obedient, keeping holy, obeying his laws. And basically, they are so refined and polished that you now see Yahushua through them. He can now see his face through them when you see them. So he is right where, they are right where he needs them to be, where he wants all of you to be. But the two-thirds, the unruly, still disobedient, still lukewarm, are the ones who, they don't get it. And they need an even tougher furnace test for them to actually show themselves worthy, because they still are not standing up for the Most High. They're still living in the world, living according to the world. So the test gets harder. It gets harder. Now, all of this stuff that comes up is going to show, prove your worth in terms of, are you going to choose Yah? Are you going to choose this other imitation, a counterfeit that has come to as a delusion to test you? Are you going to choose him? Or are you going to deny him again? Are you going to keep denying him? Because in your wicked ways, you're denying him every day. You're crucifying him over and over again every time you sin. So when I spoke about the church being, it's not a physical building, but it's a body of people that possess the same characteristics. Because if you know about spirits, spirits have fruits, right? Characteristics of these spirits. He states who they are, and he's not like a parent who is admonishing their child. They're not telling them this in order to rat on them. It's because of love. I remember my mother told me, and this is how a parent should not be. She's so into herself that she was okay with the fact that when someone harassed me, as long as it wasn't her, she was good. That's a narcissistic parent for you. As long as they weren't harassing her, as long as they weren't coming at her in order to affect her, she was good. So she don't care. She wasn't warning anybody. She's just stepping out, hands off, because the person wasn't bothering her. But the Most High sent Yahushua because he kept looking out for his people. And he doesn't want for this to happen, but stubborn, stiff-necked us can't get it right. Those of us who cannot get it right. Because there's still people around here who are using the scriptures and trying to make themselves God. And you could see how frustrating that could be when he's given you so much and he still decides you want more. So the tribulation is for those people. The other seven, because it's seven churches and only one has proven worthy. Seven churches, one proven worthy. I saw someone who said something about, oh, the 2/3 had already died from in Isaiah with the slave trade. Honey, stop misinterpreting the Bible in order to feed your own ego. Okay, Zechariah, who had that seer, they called a sickle seer anointing, he and the Most High had been directing me to Zechariah a lot, even when it came to letting his people know that the Gentilian rule was coming to an end. Also, when it comes to where he spoke about the 1/3 that will be saved and the 2/3 that have to go through it and will make it. He already foresaw all that and he put it in scripture. But then some hard hearing want to be their own, you know, take God out of the picture and make God into what they want it to be, even though you see his character is in the scripture. That's his inspired word. Okay? That's his word. And they find some words. When you start to behave like your oppressor, then your end will be like your oppressor. It's already written in the outcome for them. Only one church proved worthy. And what did he say? If you don't believe me, really look at it. That one church that found no blame, what did he say? He will hide them from that final hour of temptation. To test the wording. Final hour of temptation. What's the temptation? It's a test. If y'all think I'm just here blowing off steam and running my mouth and letting out hot air, it's not something that I myself has put out there. A couple years ago, I didn't know any of this. I'm reading the scripture just mind-boggled. What is going on? Like, I'm reading it with, I think this is what is going on, but who is he really talking to? You know? Now, in essence, it's not by my, but it's not by my might, not by my power, nothing. It is all by the Spirit of the Most High Yah. All glory be to him. Now you're looking at it with a fresh pair of eyeballs and the spiritual blindness out of the way, spiritual clarity. And it shows you he will hide them from that hour of temptation. So all of y'all who are acting all fearful and scared to stand up for the Most High and be who he told you all that you are, be all you can be because of who he is in you. He told you he's going to protect his people from the final hour of temptation. That hour when everything starts to hit the fan and everybody starts to lose their marbles. Y'all ever see when people start praying is when calamity and all kinds of disasters. You didn't even know some people knew God existed. Some people who completely took him out of their minds. Suddenly, they're hitting their knees and bawling and crying out to Yah. So all of the, and you see even the heathens, the Edomites and everything. Their understanding is instead of repenting, they wanna tighten things more, which shows you they want to take away freedom of speech. Oh, wait. What freedom of speech? Was there ever any freedom of speech in your captivity? Just a delusion. Strong delusion, anyone? It's all a part of it because his people don't take him seriously and they love the things of the world more than the Most High Yah. The final hour of temptation. It's saying, he told you what it is. Precept upon precept, line by line, here a little, there a little. He tells you what this was all about. That revelation's all about you. Mainly the stubborn ones. The remnant's gonna be with him, fighting the beast. It's gonna overcome them because it's gonna show that only one has always been your savior. All the time. And it's Yahushua, Yahuwah. Always been them. Not no man. He said, what? No man. So the remnant is still man. So no man can buy you out of that. There'll come a time when he says, come out of them, my beloved, so you don't participate of their plagues and the curses. And then there will be the Exodus. The second Exodus, he call you out. So all of those people who are like, let's go, and you get. Only he will tell you to move when it's time to move. The Israelites couldn't get out of Egypt until the Most High sent his anointed and told them to move. There's a perfect time for everything. And he is right on time all the time. So you have to trust in his timing. But in this time, when the Most High is calling his people to come back to him, and most of y'all are still in this fearfulness, another thing amongst our people that is so disgusting in ways that you can't even manage, and this is just for edification, because some of y'all don't even know what y'all are doing. There's a thing that they call colorism, shadism amongst us, which is basically you showing how much you worship the image of your oppressor. You see how there's some people amongst us because they're close enough to their oppressor, not knowing their oppressor is already, they're going to be going into their oppression very soon. They're over there still emulating
the physical looks. Beauty has not released us from the curse, none yet. Beauty has not caught, even when you think you done slept up with somebody, their whatever's going on with them still hasn't passed down to you. Okay? Even after they done pit y'all against each other, when it comes to them being a united front, you're not even involved. You just serve a purpose. And when that purpose is done, then you're done. Typical narcissistic. Love bomb you, then gaslight you, then discard you. Think about it like that in a narcissistic framework. All still demonic as it is, but all still in the grand plan of things for Israel, the two-third that is still going through their isms to get it together. Okay? You still over there hating your brother or your sister. You still there talking down your to the women, tearing them apart. The women think that they're getting back at the men because if they go and do the same things that they do, you're not. Two wrongs don't make a right. The people who continue to tear down their brothers and sisters because they didn't come out with the oppressor's skin color. Yes, the people don't talk about that a lot. And then when they try to cry out and say what they're going through, you quick and shut them up and talk about yourself. That is pride and narcissism, idolatry right there. So when people are like, what are you talking about? That's because that's stuff in yourself you don't see happening. As a watchman, a watchwoman on the side, the Most High has allowed me to observe things like this that's happening that is causing our people to get into a serious state of degradation. Falling into traps because you love yourself and your image more than you love the Most High and His image. Because better believe those people, because you know why they set you against the dark-skinned people? So they can be the most torn down, deep. They're going through a refinement that when they're done and if they pass, then they're going to rise up to be the judges who in the end of the second judgment, the second death, will be judging you. Scripture says, he who is filled or full will hunger, and he who is laughing and mocking right now, you will be mourning. So you continue to mock your brother, your sister, your cousin, your auntie, whoever, children, who still have a stronger image of the Most. That's why they don't like them. Because it reminds them of who they no longer are and how far they have fallen even more from grace than you. See, you still have a saving grace because the Most High loves you. But there are people who still say, oh, well, they can be saved. But they can't, they won't. Right now, what they're going to do, like Pharaoh did, because he was in his own understanding and the spirit, wicked spirits were upon him, he's going to tighten the leash even more. It's gonna get worse before it gets better. Because there's some people like the Most High noticed in Israel who they still weren't even ready to come out of their captivity because they didn't even realize that they were captives. They thought it was a better choice to stay in their captivity and get whipped and killed and downtrodden and mistreated. Even now in our own, we got people coming up against each other, mistreating each other. They have become the overseers and the slave master. Slave master don't even have to do nothing anymore. He just set them up as watchdogs to go attack. And you don't even understand what y'all are doing. And look, if y'all come and say, oh, well, I'm doing anything race, that's not even racism. That's not even colorism, but it is an observation that not enough people have taken note of. Not enough. There's some stuff that is messing with a lot of our people who they claim that they're Israelites and they're black. But then, you know, just the right thing to say to a darker skinned person to cut them where they can never come back from that. You will say some things and cut them so deep. When you cause another one to go astray from the Most High, when you cause that, that's on you. So you keep cutting them because you over there living like you think you in the slave master world because you got a little extra light skin and you don't even understand how you doing yourself. They themselves got what they're doing, or they got where they're going set out. If you want to keep acting like them, you're going to go where they're going. And there's a point when it's okay to be nice and soft and sweet and lovely to people, but then there's some things that's going on amongst us. And just like it has to get worse before it gets better for you to see the error of your ways, because you have your own people that you call, we're all Israelites in this. You call them your family, but then you treat them like shh. Yeah. You treat them like that. Because you would probably treat Yahushua like that. Probably treat him the same way. Because you're full of yourselves. There are others who are out there chasing after the lust of other women, and so they'll add them to the tribes. Okay. You can't keep disenfranchising others because you preaching one thing and you doing another thing. It's double-minded. And the Most High says the double-minded is it's a double-minded person is unstable. So if you can't get it together and understand, one minute you claim to know the truth, and then the next minute you over there doing the complete opposite, those are some things that you all need to look at. Like, that is one of the big things, is that people don't think that they're doing anything wrong when it comes to mistreating their brothers and sisters. They're over there crying out because of the mistreatment. I mean, they are being refined for whatever else is coming for them. But it's how you react when you decide to choose, you know, that's that on that. And the other thing also comes with, y'all still letting your enemies tell you, other nations tell you about scripture. Okay. Understand, take this in mind when you are reading. Remember, they got to where they are because by default, because y'all, us, our ancestors moved away from the Most High because of sin. And so they jumped on in and were able to overtake us. Understand that in this world, when they say the victor rewrites history. So when they tell you that this name is located here, remember they have been changing names up, calling things on maps, changing up dates, doing all kinds of things in an effort to confuse you. So keep that in mind. The victor rewrites history. So whatever was done before by what was a world of color is now undone by a world who gave up their humanity for the world, or to gain the things of the world and gain an advantage over their brother. So Revelations is all about y'all. And when the two-thirds, that, and y'all know we got some strong-minded people. If you even look at some of these comments, too, when people respond, they're like, you need to be more forgiving to one another. That is true. But just because a person comes on a firm chastisement or a little shaking up does not mean that you haven't forgiven them. Because remember, when it comes to a nation or as a whole, we all undergo and are undergoing the same things. That's why they look at us as one. One does it, everybody does it. They look at us as one. That's why we should look at them as one too. So when one or two went and they decide they want to go form covenants with the heathens and commit fornications with them, even though they had a covenant with the Most High, go looking outwards and disobeying, they needed a good stern shaking up, but they didn't get one enough. So here we are. We can't keep babying people. Look at them. They're coddling and babying their people. And they keep doing the same thing over and over again. They can't get up out their opioids or their estate because they've coddled them. That's what coddling does. Coddling causes people to continue to go back to their old ways until it completely destroys them. When they don't, when they are not reprimanded and they're not told the error of their ways, and, you know, one of those things where you gotta administer some tough love like the Most High is doing to Israel, the 144 that have been refined are the ones that he's telling you they've gone through, they've got it, everything that he's been trying to tell Israel for the whole scripture since Genesis, from he called the world into being, they've got it. So he's not gonna let the whole shit go down no more. He gonna save those ones, and then the two-thirds that haven't been refined, they clearly need some extra pushing. So it's all in it, because when people say, when I say it's a test, and I'm not saying this on my own, because I didn't know this either, okay, and I wasn't even reading the scripture that hard. It just came to you. When the Spirit comes to you, it is true. He does write the scriptures in you. It no lie. These things just come to you, and then you go into scripture and you verify it. The Holy Spirit took us out, training, observing, things He wants you to see, all that. There's no other school better than the school of the Most High. Some of us, we have to go through some hard lessons as well. It's a part of the refining stage, but some, because there's some people who really are still living in deja vu. They don't get it. They look at, as we said before, you look at your darker skin counterparts, and if you around your enemy, you ain't making them nervous, you're not doing something right. You're not doing something right. The image of the Most High is out of you that much. Then again, also, if you're doing the things of the Most High, He will let your enemies live at peace with you too. But then in some cases, you know that's not the case. So, some, they still claim to be Israel, but they're not refined enough. So that's why the tribulation is happening. It's gonna happen. Everything else that comes down to it has to happen, because he's still trying to see if, I mean, he knows the outcome, but it's been set in order to happen like a well-oiled machine. It's been extended even more. And that's why when it comes down to there and everything goes down, he's like, crunch time. What you gonna do? Who you gonna choose? Y'all ain't choose him before. You choose the popular life. He done sent people time and time and time again to warn y'all, and y'all call them Sadducees and Pharisees and hypocrites and scribes, and they just judging you. And there's a difference when people are unwillingly, well, not unwillingly, but unfairly judging you, versus when people are convicting you or chastising you because of the love that the Most High has put in them. Because it's his love for you. They, as I said before, if someone don't love you, they're not going to say nothing. You got people out there, y'all got friends around you. They see, they would see your whole life go down, and they could warn you that so-and-so been sleeping out, but they're not going to tell you. Some of them might go ahead and be the problem in your life because they want your life. When they're quiet, and they don't tell you nothing. They just let you let it all come down on you and rain down. And when you need them, they are nowhere to be found. Don't know. Israel didn't know when they had it good. And here we go again. So, yep. And that's just the general picture of it all. One out of the seven churches got it. That is, all seven is Yah Israel. There was a time also, even in scripture, if you look where John was, he was on the Isle of Patmos. You know, according to their mapping right now, the Isle of Patmos was located in Asia. It was located in Asia, where they had the Caucasus Mountain, where we could go into history with that, but I'm not trying to start nothing. Okay. Right there. So, people were spread out too. So there's a lot happened. But the victors do rewrite history, but they can also change stuff around. Or not. We just didn't have the information. So, with that, shalom and blessings for the rest of your week.
These songs of freedom, 'cause all I ever have, redemption songs, emancipate yourselves from mental slavery, none but ourselves can free our minds, have no fear for atomic energy, none of them can stop the time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Some say it's just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the book.